Week 4 of Back to Biz Basics, I'm Jon Schwabish, and today we're going to build a bar chart based on the famous W.E.B. Du Bois bar chart of acres of land owned. So this is the graph we're being asked to recreate. As you can see, the title here is Acres of Land Owned by Negroes in Georgia from 1874 down to 1899. There's a label in the top bar, a label in the bottom bar. Fairly straightforward graph. Now, the instructions for Back to Viz Basics are not to create an exact replica. That's not what we have to do for this. That's what I'm going to do this time. Not an exact replica, but I'm just going to make it in Flourish, going to keep it very simple. So this will be a relatively straightforward graph. So here's what I'm going to create. You can see I've got that sort of, you know, brownish, tannish background. I've got the red bars. I'm going to label all of them. I'm going to put the label at the end. I'm not going to label all of them because I want to. I actually tried to get the label on just the first and just the last and couldn't get it to work in Flourish. So, but this is what we're going to create. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to right click, open my week four folder here and create a new visualization. And we're just going to grab ourselves a nice little bar chart here. And let's go over to our data tab to get started. So I'm going to upload the data. I've already got this teed up in my folder here. It's Excel data. Import that. Let Flourish this time just tell me how everything should work. We've got the year. We've got the acres owned. We are in good shape. Let's go over here. And now we can just do some styling. I mean, this is really just kind of straightforward styling is really all we need to do for this particular visualization. So I'm going to go to my notes over here so I can get the right color because I want to use that red color. So first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to change the color here. And again, if you remember the custom override for color, that kind of the, I think, fastest or easiest way to do this is just put your variable name, colon, and then the color code. I'm using hex codes 143C, and that should give us, there's the red color. And while I'm doing colors, I'm going to go down to layout at the bottom to change the background color. And I'm going to change that to, let's see, I have that written down here. I think this is what it is, 9DECD. There we go, we've got that. Okay, so you can see we're well on our way. So we've got a few other changes to make here. Let's just take a look at the bottom, the x-axis. We don't need, we're going to add the labels. So actually, let's just get rid of the x-axis altogether. So that's done. We don't really need that. And now let's take a look at the y-axis. We want every label. Now notice it's not labeled 1874 and it goes to 1900, which I find is kind of interesting because I think if I created this graph in Excel, and let's do that. If I created this graph in Excel right here, I think the way Excel is going to do this is it's going to say, see, it's going to start at 18. It's the wrong direction. So that's just a weird thing about Excel. So we'll just fix that. But as you can see here, it starts at the first. Now it's adding every year. I think if I blow this font up, it will reduce the size. Let's see. There we go. So as you can see, what Excel does actually is start in the first year. Even though I might want to label every other year or every 5 years, it's always going to start in that first year. So I think that's kind of interesting. It doesn't go to 1899. So Flourish is kind of rounding up, which is kind of interesting, and not starting in that first year. We can fix that. Doesn't really matter. Just find it kind of interesting. We can fix that by just setting the min and the max. So 1874, 1899, and that's going to go to 1899 down there, but it's not labeled. So we need to actually tell it to label, add the label for each one. So we can do that here by just doing the styling, and we can change our labels here. Whoop, I don't want one. I actually want to have 25. So I put one here. So it's like my instinct is every year, but it's really just the number of years that you want. So you have to put in 25. So that's a little bit of a thought that you need to sort of think about. With ticks, I actually don't want the tick mark. You can see there's like a white tick mark there. I'm just going to get rid of those by just setting the width down to zero, and that just makes it disappear. So I'm getting nice and close here. Let's turn that legend off. Don't need that. Let's get our labels on. So let's show labels on our data points. There we go. And we'll keep them inside the bar. That looks fine. We need to actually set the number formatting here. So I don't want the decimals. I don't need the decimals here. So let's just turn the decimals off. And whoop, I don't need negative one. Let's go to zero. And I think we're pretty good. I think we're pretty good here. Now, again, if you've watched some of the previous videos, you know that depending on your data, you might need to go back to Excel or R, your CSV file or whatever it is, to change the formatting there before you actually get it into Flourish. But in this case, we're pretty straightforward. We don't really have to do that. Let's add a title. So we'll go with the header tab. And here we're just gonna, I'm gonna use all caps, just because that's what the original did. And I'm just gonna do owned by African American people in Georgia. We'll say 1874 to 1899. Not the most exciting title. My titling has not been great so far in this project, but I promise I'll try to do better. Let's also add a footnote in case you've been seeing, I've been adding some footnotes here. So I'm just gonna say back to Viz Basics week number 4. And I'll just leave that there. And you can see that it shows up down here. I could add a URL here. I'm not gonna do that, but I could link that as well. Last thing I wanna do is change the font. I don't wanna use the font that's being used. So I'm gonna go back to layout. Now you can go grab different fonts, and I haven't really started to play around with different font types, but you can grab fonts from Google Fonts and get them into your Flourish instance. I haven't started to do that yet, but if we go back to the original, it's not quite a serif font, but it's a little bit blockier. Let's just try it. We'll just use a serif font for this one. So here is my graph. I've got the red bars. I got the white font. I'm going to keep it white. Now, I just clicked over, acre zone. I actually don't think I need pop-ups here. Like, are the pop-ups necessary? So let's actually go in and just turn those off. Like, I don't need them at all. It's just a bar chart. But if I were, I would certainly change what's in here. And as we go further, through this, project of creating these graphs, we're going to learn how to really style these pop-ups. We're going to start adding links to the pop-ups. We're going to add images to the pop-ups. There's some really cool stuff that we can do in the tooltips. But for this case, I don't think I actually need them, so I'm going to turn them off. So fairly straightforward graph. Make sure you name it. Makes your life a little bit easier. We'll call this Du Bois bar chart, and then it will show up in your week 4 folder. So again, if you have questions, let me know. Use the hashtag B2VB on Twitter or LinkedIn. Make sure you follow Eric's site, Eric Balish, who is one of the main, one of the co-organizers of the Back to Viz Basics. Make sure you put your final visualization in his Google form on the main website. And yeah, let me know if you have any questions. I hope you're enjoying learning Flourish. And until next week, this is the Back to Viz Basics project, Flourish edition.